The first thing I wanted to teach was how to set up a scene. So I loaded in some free assets from the asset store and started to create the prototype world. The links for these assets can be found in the video description. The lighting and the shadows didn't have the right look, so I went into the rendering settings and fine-tuned them until I got the desired result. After changing the rendering settings and the settings on the material, I got the desired prototype look I was going for. However, I still didn't like the metallic look on the robot, so I had to remove it to make it look more simplistic. After removing the metallic effect, I tried out the different alternate materials that came with the asset package. However, I wasn't really happy with the way they looked, so I decided to create my own. I figured that orange would be a nice bright color that would have a great contrast against the blue ground. The new orange texture finally gave the robot the look I was going for. I decided to let the students put together a house from different parts to teach them how to use the different tools that can manipulate with the transform component. I wanted to get a higher quality skybox, so I found one in the asset store and added it to the game. The link to this skybox can also be found in the description below the video. I've gotten a lot of comments about the new input system, so I figured that I should use that in my Udemy course. So far I'm not very impressed with it. I feel like you need to do way too much work just to do a simple thing that would take one line of code in the old input system. However, I'm still gonna try out the system a bit more before I write it off completely. So I wrote the last lines of code and then I was ready to test out the system. Okay, so I had to debug to find out that the input actions aren't enabled from the get-go, so I had to write some code to enable them before it would work. And I was finally able to move the player. Next up would be setting up the camera, and then after that I would have to add some animations to him. Writing the camera script actually took quite a while. I think I used half a day's work just testing different camera scripts, rewriting the code over and over again until I got it exactly as I wanted it. I ended up writing a script that would allow me to turn the player with the mouse and orbit around him if I hold down right click. The moment that I would let go of the right click, it will orbit back to its original position behind the player. Finally, I got to the animations. I always love to set up animations when I create games because it's always interesting to see how it makes the characters come to life. In the beginning, I used the basic animations that came with the Jammo asset package. However, I also wanted to teach my students about blend trees, so I had to head over to Mixamo to get some animations that I could use for blending. I got a strafe left and right animation that I would use to blend with Jammo's walk animation. At first I didn't get the movement quite right, but after some fine-tuning I ended up with some very nice and smooth movement. On the left you can see the first attempt, where the movement is kinda clunky when I change directions. On the right you see the final result, with smooth transitions between directions. Even though I had a player controller that could idle, walk, run, and jump, I still needed to add a couple of more animations. I couldn't find the animations that I needed on Mixamo, so I had to create my own in Blender. I wanted to create some animations that I could use while doing other things, for example walking at the same time as playing this animation, because I wanted to demonstrate what an avatar mask could do. To do that, I added a wave animation and I also created a finger gun animation that we'll use to make the robot shoot later in the course. After creating the animations in Blender, I pulled them into Unity and created an avatar mask for the left and the right arm. After that, I created a layer for each arm and then I set up the animations. After setting up the layers with avatar masks, I tested it out and the animations worked perfectly. I feel like it looked awesome and creepy at the same time, because there's something scary about a robot walking slowly towards you while it's shooting at you with his finger gun and waving. It's gonna be very interesting to see what it's gonna look like when we're going to make him shoot lasers from his fingers later. And that's it for this devlog. Thank you so much for watching. If you liked the video, then please don't forget to smash the like button, because it would really help me out a lot. I also want to take a moment to say thanks to all my patrons, because I wouldn't be able to keep making these videos without you, so thank you so much for all your support. I'd also like to say thanks to Joshua and Richter for their tier 3 sub this month, and special thanks to James Williams Bond and Medilla for their tier 4 sub this month. Also, if you are interested in learning about the things that I showed in this devlog, you can click the link in the description below the video to learn how to enroll on my Udemy course. What are you still doing here? You can click the link on the screen to go to my Patreon page or click one of my other videos and watch them. And of course, if you haven't done it, then you can click the subscribe button. Thanks. You're still here? Okay.